Are you blind when you're born?
Can you see in the dark?
Dare you look at a king?
Would you sit on his throne?
Can you save your bite that it's worse than your bark?
Are you cock of the walk?
When you're walking alone,
because jellicles can and jellicles do. Jellicles do and jellicles can.
We can turn double somersaults, bounce on a tire.
We can run up a wall.
We can swing through the trees.
We can balance on bars. We can walk on a wire.
Thank you. Announces the cat who can now be reborn and come back to a different Jellicle life. For waiting up there is the heavy side player, full of wonders one Jellicle only will see. And Jellicle's ask becomes Jellicle's dare. Who will it be?
Stripes and leopard spots, all they
the stair, or on the steps, or on the mat. She sits and sits and sits and sits, and that's what makes a grumpy cat. That's what makes a grumpy cat.
But when the day's hustle and bustle is done, then the grumpy cat's work complete but hardly begun. And then all the family's in bed and asleep, she tucks on her skirts to the basement to creep. She's deeply concerned with the ways of the mice.
Their behavior's not good and their manner's not nice.
So when she has gotten them lined up on the mat, she teaches them
music, crochet, and tatting.
I have a gummy cat in mind. Her name is Jenny Any Dots. The curtain cord she likes to wind. Sailor knots. She sits upon the windowsill or anything that's smooth and flat. She sits and sits and sits and sits, and that's what makes a grumpy cat. That's what makes a grumpy cat.
Thank you. Mungo Jerry.
Oh, a rumpel teaser.
And once got a time, well, they'll leave it at that.
Mungo, Jerry, and your rumble teaser have an unusual gift of the gab.
We are highly efficient cat burglars as well.
And the lovely smart at a smash and grab.
We make our home in Victoria Grove. We have no regular occupation. We are plausible fellows who like to engage
a friendly police bunion conversation.
Oh, when the family assembles for Sunday dinner, their minds made up that they wouldn't get dinner. An Argentine joint, potatoes and greens, then the cook will appear from behind the scenes
and say in a voice that is broken with sorrow, I'm afraid like that. Then the family'll say,
it's that horrible cat.
Was it Mungo Jerry?
Or Rumpelteazer?
And most of the time, they leave it at that.
Mungo Jerry and Rumpelteazer have a wonderful way of working together. And some of the time, you would say it was luck. And some of the time, you would say it was weather.
on the night we make the Jellicle choice. And now that the Jellicle leader is here, Jellicle cats can all rejoice! Everyone knows our proud and implacable passionate foes. It is always the same wherever one goes. And the pugs and the palms, although most people say that they do not like fighting yet once in a way, they will now and again join into the fray. And they until you can hear them all over the park. And they until you can hear them all over the park. Now on the occasion of which I shall speak, almost nothing had happened for nearly a week. And that's a long time for a fall or a peak. The pig police dog was away from his beat. I don't know the reason, but most people think he slipped into the Wellington Arms for a drink. And no one at all was about on the street when a peak and a pup happened to meet. Not advance or exactly retreat, but they glared at each other and scraped their hind feet and started to
bark
until you could hear them all over the park. And they
bark
until you could hear them all over the park. Now the people, although people may say what they please, is no British dog, but an heathen Chinese. And so all the pigs, when they heard the uproar, some came to the window, some came to the door. There were surely a dozen, or likely a score, and together they started to grumble and wheeze in their huffery, snuffery, heathen Chinese. But a terrible thing is what follicles like, for your follicle dog is a dour Yorkshire type.
Amazing.
out through the bars of the moon. You never saw anything fiercer or hairier. And what with the glare of his eyes and his calling, the peace and the follicles quickly took warning. He looked at the sky and he gave a great leap, and then every last one of them scattered like sheep. And when the police dog returned to his feet, there wasn't a single one left on the street.
Come to Whenever he joins his friends at their club, which takes place at the 70 speeches by heart. I'd extemporize my chat. I knew how to gag, and I knew how to let the cat out of the bag. I knew how to act, my back and my tail. But an hour of rehearsal, I never could fail. But a voice that will soften the hardest of hearts, oh, whether I took the lead.
Yeah. master's daughters would be searching the high and low. Same skibble, very skibble, unless he's very nimble, then the night mail just can't go. At 11:42, with the funeral overdue, and the passengers all frantic to a man, that's when I would hear and I'd saunter to the rear, I'd be busy in the luggage van.
Thank you. Discover them, my cavity, my cavity, my cavity. Task, Mr. Mustafa.
The original conjuring cat. There can be no doubt about that. Please, listen to me. And don't scoff. All his inventions are off his own bat. There's no such cat in the metropolis. He holds all the patent monopolies for performing surprising illusions and creating eccentric confusions. The greatest magicians have something to learn from Mr. Mistopheles, conjuring turns. And you'll all say, oh, And never was there ever a cat so clever as magical Mr. Mistopheles. He's quiet, he's small, he's black. From his ears to the tip of his tail, he can creep through the tiniest crack. He can walk on the narrowest rail. He can pick any card from a pack. He's equally cunning with dice. He's always deceiving you into believing that he's only hunting for mice. He can play any trick with a cock or a spoon and a bit of fish paste. And if you look for a knife or a fork and you think it is merely misplaced, you'll see it in one moment and then it is gone. But you'll find it next week lying out on the lawn. And we all say, oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magic Mr. Mistopheles. Oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magic Mr. Mistopheles. His manner is vague and aloof. You would think there was nobody shyer, but his voice has been heard on the roof. While he was curled up by the fire, he sometimes been heard by the fire. When he was about on the roof, at least they all heard that somebody purred, which is incontestable proof. Ow! Of his singular magical powers, I've known the family to call him in the garden for hours while he was asleep in the hall. And not long ago, this phenomenal cat produced 7 kittens right out of a hat. And we all say, oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magic to Mr. Mistopheles. Oh, well, I never was there ever a cat so clever as magic to
announces the cat, who can now be reborn and come back to a different.